Hello everyone. Let's look at the journey of India and the markets in the last 25 years. You'll remember at the turn of the century, we had the tech boom, the IT boom, the telecom, media, technology stocks did very well. Then came a phase where the focus shifted to infra, specifically roads, power, irrigation. We saw good jump in India's earnings growth. We were met with a financial crisis in 2008. But Indian economy remained strong and came back very quickly from that shock. Then we had a phase of the last 10 years of growing government capex, improvement in retail lending and financing. We saw even during COVID, India actually recovered very quickly and very well. Now we have reached a stage where Indian per capita income is at $2,500 and growing. India is one of the fastest growing countries compared to emerging markets as well as developed markets. The Indian consumer earlier in the century saw a rise in incomes, but mainly it was for necessities. The bottom of the pyramid became the middle part of the pyramid. The triangle became more like a diamond, and we had the rising middle class. With penetration of financing, the spending and consumption sectors grew. In the next two decades now, we will see a big transformation in the consumer sectors. We will move from necessities to aspirations, and then from aspirations to luxury. As we move towards Viksit Bharat or a developed economy, we will see a good boom in the consumption sector in India. We see four mega trends in the Indian consumption sector. First is consume more. Second, consume better. Third, consume well. And fourth, consume easy. In all these trends, India will see growth and penetration of consumer services and products. Let me start with the first one. Consume more. As per capita income rises, the penetration of goods and services increases as well as the frequency of consumption increases. Today, India is still, in terms of per capita consumption, lower than many of the emerging as well as developed economies. Emerging economies like China or Russia or Brazil, they consume more paints, for example, per household compared to India. US is definitely four times bigger a paints market than Indian market. So as per capita income rises, people will spend higher and higher proportion of income on discretionary consumption and less on, say, food or basic necessities. Engel's law says that as per capita income rises, people increase the percentage of spend in consumer discretionary items like household appliances, or white goods and certain areas like paints or cars, automobiles. The second trend is about consuming better, which is in a way saying premiumization. The middle class is aspiring to premiumize and increase their spend on some of the premium products in each category. A few examples could be liquid soaps. The growth rate has been about 7% more than regular soap bars. Growth in consumption of green tea, for example, is growing at 17% more than the consumption in regular tea. The best example could be SUVs in the auto sector. Within the passenger car market, 10 years back, SUVs were about 15% of the sales. Now they have reached about 45% of sales. The aspiring middle class, the aspiring youngsters are spending more on experiences and premiumization, whether it is categories like hotels, QSRs, or travel, or on categories which are of daily consumption, where they prefer a better brand or a more premium product. The third important trend in consumption is consume well. This theme is about consuming what is right for you, what is healthy for you. Specifically after COVID, a lot of people have become very conscious about the products that they are consuming. There is a lot of focus on healthcare and wellness. So within consumption, people are picking up those brands which are better for them. Now, you would have seen on social media a lot of talk recently about products, say, which have higher sugar content. Such kind of debates were very scanty or rarely talked about earlier. So people are getting more conscious about consuming well. Also, there is some kind of consciousness about picking up brands and picking up products from companies which are socially and environmentally responsible. Overall, the consumption sector in India is seeing a good wave of wellness consumption or consuming well. The last trend, and which is a very recent trend, is a sharp pickup in consume easy or consuming at convenience. The rise in online shopping, e-commerce, quick commerce, deliveries, you would have seen it that India wants to consume at convenience. Indian consumer is demanding things at the doorstep. This has helped the businesses too. Right package sizing in food items, ready to eat or ready to cook items. You would have also seen a lot of brands which are starting off new are able to reach their consumers much faster than traditional channels. Consume Easy is helping customers as well as companies address this rising demand. Why should you think about investing in the consumption sector currently? When you look at consumption companies, typically these are companies which have a long cycle. So they are long cycle plays. They are also capital efficient. They have cash rich balance sheets. They also give high dividends to their shareholders. We also see consumer companies have strong competitive advantage. So they are able to give you longer and visible growth. At this point of time, why is it important to look at consumption? As I mentioned earlier, India has gone through different sectors growing over the last 25 years. A lot of investment has gone into the economy in different capex areas, both from government as well as private sector. Now is the time for consumption to pick up. Whenever an economy crosses $2,500 per capita income, we've seen it in China, in South Africa, in South Korea. In all these places, the consumption sector sees a transformational change. And we are at the cusp of that change in India. Even in terms of valuations, we've seen in the recent past, in the last 2 years, capex cycle or capex companies have seen significant re-rating upwards in valuation. The consumer companies are attractively placed considering their growth and quality metrics. Introducing the Bajaj Finserv Consumption Fund. The fund invests in those companies that benefit from these mega trends in the consumption sector. Happy investing.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risk. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.